Dermot Kearney reporting for finalwhistle.ie this evening on a night where it is certainly a case of deja vu for Kerry FC as they once again suffer a 2-1 defeat to Finn Harps this season. 2 months ago, it was a 2-1 scoreline at Mount Hawk Park, but in the same amount of time, it is another 2-1 win for the home side, Finn Harps, this evening, ending a 2-month wait for a big 3 points in the league standings. Kerry did start with intent from the off, however. On the right wing, Sean McGrath crossed in for Ryan Kelleher inside the 6-yard box, but Antonio Tuta came out well and managed to sniff out the danger. Kerry did keep the pressure going. Leo Gaxa found Daniel Okude, but Okude's effort from outside of the box was wayward and landed out for a goal kick. Harps did start to get into the game with a couple of chances. BJ Banda from an acute angle had an effort that went wide before Patrick Ferry crossed to the back post that Sam Aladisanusi had to head clear. Harps did keep the pressure going, but for large spells of the opening half, it was very much a stalemate between the two sides. They went in deadlocked at the break. But just before the break, Ryan Kelleher had a great chance, but again, Tuta managing to sniff out the danger. Smart goalkeeping from the Croatian as he managed to close the angle a bit. Kelleher tried to loft the ball over him from close range, but it went out for a goal kick. It was an absolute whirlwind, however, start to the second half as Kelleher made it 1-0 to Kerry just 3 minutes into proceedings. Daniel Okude down the right wing fired a ball across the 6-yard box, and there was Kelleher to tap home from close range. 3 minutes later, however, Finn Harps would find themselves level. Tony McNamee floating a free kick to the back post where BJ Banda got a glancing header, but it was just enough to take it past Lee Axworthy and landed into the Kerry goal. Noah Baba was a half-time substitute for Finn Harps. He would pick up a yellow card not too long after Banda's opener and did maybe find himself a little bit on thin ice not to get a second yellow card a few minutes later. But just after the hour mark, it was his header that went into the back of the Kerry net from a Ryan Flood corner that would prove pivotal in Finn Harps putting themselves into a situation where they would take 3 points in this contest. However, there was still more drama to come. 15 minutes left on the clock. Seamus Keogh was adjudged to have handled a cross going into the box. Referee pointed to the spot. Up stepped Leo Gaxa. His effort went to the left-hand bottom corner, but Tuta got down well and with a strong hand palmed away the ball to keep Finn Harps in the lead. For those final 15 minutes, Harps were defending well. Kerry kept the pressure going, but just was not to be this evening. They now have two home games in a row to try and end the season on a high point in their inaugural season, while Finn Harps could find themselves further up the league standings. They're currently second from bottom, but we will see in a few weeks where they can finish up. As it finished in Finn Park this evening, Finn Harps 2, Kerry FC 1.